We're going to take a nice vinyasa flow tonight. I've got a nice new flow for you. Onto your knees and just turn those palms upwards so they're facing up towards the sky and drop your shoulders down. So just give yourself a little wiggle here, just wiggle those hips, wiggle your bums, wiggle the shoulders. Just make sure that you are nice and comfortable in your space. So it's really important that even if you've got a tiny amount of space, that you feel mentally like you've got enough space to do whatever you want to do. So we're just going to bring ourselves into a nice, calm state of mind. So let's close our eyes, take that nice deep inhale through the nose, expand our abdomen and send all of that air down towards the bottom of your lungs. Fill them like a glass all the way to the top. And as you exhale, release the breath and draw the navel in towards the spine. And keep that breath flowing. With every inhale, we try and take it even deeper. Always teach your body to use the full capacity of your lungs. And as we're breathing, we want to feel the space around us grow. We want to feel limitless. And as we inhale, we lengthen to straighten our spine. Make sure we're not slouched over, extending through our neck and planting our sit bones nice and sturdy on the mat. Grounding down through our seat, but still feeling light. Deep inhale here. And exhale, we start to tune out now all distractions, thoughts, and worries. If you've had a stressful day, I just want you to take all of those thoughts, anything that's stressing you out, and I want you to take an imaginary broom, and we're just gonna sweep everything away, sweep the mind nice and clear. We want our head light and free of worry. And for everyone that has had a bit of a rubbish day, for anyone that's feeling a little bit like, okay, we've done a week on lockdown now and you're a bit over it, I just want you to think of one small thing that you're grateful for. It can be anything. It can be a home-cooked meal. It can be the fact that we can still connect even via the internet and do this practice and free as well, which is just so lovely. And I just want you to connect to that one feeling, that one thought, and allow that little feeling of gratitude to push you through your practice. We did inhale to wash the feeling of gratitude through us. Inhale. And exhale. And again, inhale. Drop your shoulders down away from the ears as you exhale, feeling the shoulder blades gliding down your spine, trickling towards the mat. And inhale to lengthen through your spine, making sure we're not slouching, neck long, creating space between our shoulders and our ears. Unclench your jaw and unlock those back teeth. Make sure they're not touching. And just let the tongue drop down from the roof of your mouth. Maybe your mouth is slightly open as you breathe. Just unfurrow your brow. Make sure you're not frowning. Make sure your facial features are soft and relaxed. We hold on to stress in really subtle ways. So just feel the difference. If you drop those shoulders, unclench the jaw and soften your features, almost like a release. And as we inhale, we feel ourselves grounding into the mat, staying light, but staying nice and grounded on our sit bones. If Feel yourself becoming one with your mat, your arms almost becoming heavy, drawing down towards the ground as your neck lengthens, your spine grows. And let's begin with a very small movement. Take your chin towards your left shoulder and gazing all the way to the right, to the left. And if you want to, you can open your eyes. If you want to keep them closed, then by all means do. And then take your gaze all the way across to the right shoulder. Gently bring your head back to center, drop your chin down onto your chest, inhale. Exhale, lift your chin towards the sky, gazing upwards. Or if your eyes are closed, just letting your head roll back. Gently bring yourself back to center. Clasp your fingers at the front. Imagine you're hugging a giant beach ball. Drop your chin down onto your chest. Inhale, doming the spine, spread the shoulders. Exhale, we push up towards the sky, pushing the air away, drop the shoulders down. Inhale, bending across to the left, so we stretch the right side of the body, but keep those bum cheeks glued down onto the mat. And inhale back to center. Exhale, we lean to the right, this time stretching the left side of the body. Keep space between your shoulders and your ears as you reach that bum cheek nice and planted. Inhale. Exhale. Gently bring yourself back to center. Take those arms wide, point the fingers, maybe give them a little wiggle, maybe twist the wrists, just loosening up the body, getting the synovial fluids flowing, getting into every nook and cranny. And then exhale your arms behind. Pull your shoulder blades together and push the heart center forward, interlacing your fingers behind your back and breathe. Inhale. And exhale. And if you want to, you can even hinge forward through the hips here and reach your arms out behind you to get deeper into your shoulders. And gently roll up through the spine. And let's take our right hand behind us like a secondary spine, and your left hand comes to the outside of your right knee. We're going to take a twist, so any pregnant ladies watching, please avoid twisting through the spine. It cuts off the airflow to the fetus. So just you take a seated cat-cow if you would like to, or just stay seated. Inhale, everyone else, looking over your right shoulder. Keep that right arm nice and straight behind you, and as you exhale, push that right knee away with your left hand. Keep those bum cheeks planted. Try not to lean back onto your right arm. Just keep it nice and straight. Push that knee away and twist. Gently bring yourself back to center. Left arm behind and right hand to the outside of the left knee, sitting up nice and tall as you inhale. And as you exhale, twist through the spine, gaze over that left shoulder. Deep inhale here, and exhale. Gently bring yourself back to center. Take those palms, place them in front of you on the mat. Bring yourself into an all fours position, stacking your joints. Make sure those wrists are under shoulders, knees under hips. Take a deep inhale and just ground down into the mat. Really push down through the palms, pushing into the outside of the little fingers. You almost feel like you're pushing up off the mat. So with fingertips spread nice and wide, you're pushing down through the knees, the tops of the feet and your palms, almost like you could lift off and float away. And we take a nice deep inhale here. And as you exhale, I want you to open the mouth and feel like you're fogging up a mirror. And again, inhale. And fog up that mirror. Feel it in the back of your throat. And this time, I want you to do that same fogging, but with your mouth closed. So this is our ujjayi breath. So you're going to feel it all fogging up in the back of your throat. Inhale. And again, inhale. Inhale, start to drop that navel to the floor and gaze up to the sky, keeping your breath flowing. Exhale, arching, spread the shoulder blades, drop the crown of the head towards the floor. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Hollowing out that lower back, gazing upwards. And exhale, arching, dome those shoulders, drop the crown of the head down, draw the navel in towards the spine. So maybe you're happy with your cat-cow, and maybe you want to go a little further into that flow, and you want to freestyle, wiggle the hips. You want to maybe draw circles with your spine, start to sit back on your heels, really, really get deep into that movement. Just freestyle it. Maybe let the head get involved, let your hips get involved. I want you guys to take 5 deep breaths here. Really, really get involved. Keep that breath flowing, really getting deep into your spine. And give me 5 deep breaths here. Maybe you want to rotate the back. Maybe you want to draw a figure of 8 with your hips. Whatever you want to do. And then gently bring yourself back into a child's pose. Heels together, knees apart, straighten your arms out in front and bring your forehead down onto the mat and breathe in. And exhale. Take a nice deep breath, push down through your palms, tuck those toes under and send your sit bones up towards the sky into your downward facing dog. Walk the feet out here. And with your down dog, I want you to make sure that those fingertips are spread nice and wide, heels drawing down towards the mat, a nice straight line from your tailbone all the way down to your arms, gazing between your legs or at your belly button, drawing that navel in. If you feel like you've got a dome in the spine, you can also bend the knees. It's perfectly fine to bend the knees and actually much better than having a curve in the back. Really pushing into the outside of those fingers and your palms. Deep inhale and exhale and breathe here. Inhale, we're going to raise up on our toes, lifting the heels off the mat, and exhale, lowering down. This is a really lovely one if you've got tight hamstrings and tight calves. Inhale, we raise, draw that navel in, try and keep your body in the same position as you lift, and exhale, lower heels down towards the mat. Inhale. Lovely, everyone, stay with me. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. And we're going to take one more here. Inhale, raise those heels. And exhale, dropping them back down. Inhale, bring yourself forward into your high plank, engaging the core. Make sure the wrists are underneath the shoulders. Take a nice deep breath, and you're going to drop those knees down towards the mat. Just hover them there, push your bum back towards your heels, and then push up into your downward facing dog. So we're going to take a few of those little circles. If you really don't want to, feel free to take your downward dog and just breathe into that. Or you can take your child's pose, it's completely up to you. In other words, inhale, let's drop forward, high plank. Drop the knees and push the bum back towards the heels. Reach up into your downward facing. And again, inhale, high plank, drawing that navel in, engage the core. Exhale, drop the knees, push the bum back, and send those hips up towards the sky. And again, drop forward, high plank, core engaged. Drop those knees down, push the bum back. Send those sit bones up towards the sky. Lovely, once more. High plank, core engaged. Keep that bum in line. Drop those knees, exhale the bum back, send those sit bones up towards the sky, walk your feet out here. Lovely, everybody, give those hips a little wiggle, maybe from side to side.
Take a nice deep breath, drop back into your plank, and either bring yourself down knees, chest, and chin, or if you would like to, you can tap those elbows in, come down through chaturanga, and push forward into your upward facing dog. Make sure the tops of the feet are down on the mat. Take a deep breath here, and then push yourself back into your child's pose, heels together, knees apart, straighten those arms out in front, forehead down onto the mat, gazing straight ahead. We're not pausing here for long. Inhale, exhale, push that chest along the mat and bring yourself into your extended puppy pose. So extended puppy pose, chest is down on the mat, knees and feet are parallel like train tracks, reaching your arms out in front, nice extension through the spine. You'll feel this in the back of your hamstrings. Deep breath, inhale and exhale. And inhale and exhale, pull yourself back up into your all fours position, stack those joints, tuck that right toe under and lift the right leg. Imagine that you're kicking the air away, and we're just going to draw some circles with our knee here to just release the hips. So start to draw those circles forward first, one, two, lovely, three, and back the other way, one, two, three, really nice. Drop the knee, point that toe and send your right leg out behind you nice and straight. Then you're going to draw a straight line with that right foot, bring it in line with your left and bring yourself up into your gate pose. So maybe you're happy here in your gate pose. Maybe you want to go a little further, lift the right leg and reach out the right arm. And maybe you want to go further still and you want to take that right foot behind you, bend the knee and kick that foot into your right hand, giving yourself a stretch through the shoulders and the spine. Keep that neck nice and long here and breathe into whichever version you're doing. Give me five, four, three, two, and one. Drop back down into an all fours position. Just give yourself a little wiggle through the spine. Tuck that left toe under, kick up towards the sky, bending the knees, flexing the foot, and let's do our circles. One, two, opening the hips here, three, keep that breath flowing, and back the other way, one, two, lovely, and three. Drop that knee and flex the foot and send the left leg now to the back of the mat, nice and straight. Draw a line with that left foot so it's in line with your right. Shift the weight so it's equally distributed between your right hand and your right knee and reach up towards the sky into your gate pose. Happy here, then stay here. If you want a little more, lift that back foot, reach your arm out in front, and those of you that want to go further still, kick that left leg behind you, bending the knee, and kick that foot into your left hand, stretching through the shoulders. The inhale and exhale, and inhale, and exhale, gently drop the knees down, plant the palms, take a nice deep inhale, tuck those toes under, and push back into your downward facing dog. Walk those feet out here, let's take our right leg now up towards the sky, three-legged, bend the knee and open the hips, flexing the foot. Take a nice deep inhale here, equally distribute that weight between the palms. Send that knee all the way forward to meet your chest and plant that right foot down. You're going to bring yourself into a low lunge, bringing those arms up in line with your ears. Inhale here. Make sure that your right ankle is just underneath your right knee. Inhale, we lengthen. Exhale, place those palms down. We're going to drop onto our back and straighten the front leg. So we're getting ourselves a nice hamstring stretch here. Right leg nice and straight, left leg bent. Inhale. Inhale, bring yourself back forward into a lunge position. Deep inhale here, gazing straight ahead. Exhale, drop that left knee, straighten the right leg and bring yourself forward. Inhale. And exhale, folding forward. Inhale, shifting all that weight forward. You can keep the knee on the mat if you want to. Really, really getting deep into your hips and your hamstrings here. Try and make sure that your knee is just above your ankle. And again, straighten that front leg. Deep breath. And once more, shifting all the way forward. You're going to tuck that back foot under and lift your back knee. Raise your arms up in line with your ears, nice and slowly, keeping that balance. Deep breath here. Exhale, we're going to turn out that left foot. Bring ourselves up into our warrior two. Tucking tailbone under, keeping that right leg nice and bent. I'm just going to change sides so that you guys can see what I'm doing. And also so that you can actually see the top of my head. So we're turning that left foot out, right foot facing straight ahead, arms in line with your shoulders. Inhale, lengthening through the spine, tuck that tailbone under and gaze down those front fingertips. Really nice. Inhale here, and as you exhale, tickle those left fingers down your left leg, right arm up into your reverse warrior. And if you want to, you can take that left arm all the way around so it touches your right thigh. Sitting into that front knee bend, really feeling that twist, feeling that stretch down the right side of our bodies. Inhale. Exhale, unravel the hands. Shift your weight forward, turn the palms, and bring yourself into a nice open arm stretch. Keep that front knee nice and bent. So options here, you can either stay with your arms open, or if you would like to go further still, you can bring your right arm underneath your right leg and left arm over the top and take a bind. If the arms open is causing you a little bit of a strain, pop that right forearm onto your right side and bring your left arm over the top into your extended side angle pose. Those of you in a bind, just making sure that chest is open to the side. Whichever version you're doing, it's all good. Take a nice deep breath here. And exhale. And inhale, straightening out that front leg as well. So both legs are straight. So if you've got your arms open, you'll bring yourself into your triangle pose. Everyone else keeping the bind. Take a nice deep breath here. Everyone in the bind, open those arms into your triangle. Meet everyone else here. You can try and gaze up at your extended arm. I want you to imagine here that you've been popped into a toaster. So your hips are nice and aligned. And you want to make sure you're so aligned that you don't get burnt on either side. Take a nice deep inhale. Exhale, bringing yourself upright, bring those arms in line with your ears. And we're just going to shift ourselves so we're facing straight ahead. So take finger and thumbs onto your hip bones and square them to the front. And what I want you to do is just step that back foot in a little. So your feet are about a meter to a meter, to half a meter apart. They're not as wide as they were in triangle. Take a nice deep inhale here, finger and thumb on your hip bones. And as you exhale, we're going to start to hinge forward, nice straight back. And hinge forward into your pyramid pose. We're trying to bring our torso to our thigh and our nose to our knee. Deep inhale here. And exhale. And if you've got really tight hamstrings like me, this is quite an indulgent stretch. But if it starts to hurt, really gently pull yourself back out. Take a nice deep breath. Drop both hands down on either side of that front foot, and we're going to step both feet to the top of the mat. So now you'll be in your forward fold. Bend the knees, glue the torso onto the thighs. Oops. Excuse me, don't do that. Hold onto your elbows and just let your head hang heavy, and we're just going to sway here. From side to side in our ragdoll. I'm just going to bring myself back a little bit. So just letting yourself hang loose, hang heavy. Grounding down through the feet, making sure your weight is evenly distributed. Take a nice deep inhale here, and we're going to start to very slowly unravel through the spine. One vertebrae at a time. Uncurling. Bringing yourself up to standing. Really nice and slow.
chin down onto your chest. Your head and neck will be the last things to come up. Drop those shoulders down, lengthen through the spine, lengthen through your neck. And make sure that I'm not cutting my head off. So standing nice and tall at the tops of your mats, arms down by your side. Try and make sure those feet are nice and evenly distributing the weight, palms down and open. Drop those shoulders down, take a nice deep breath here. Inhale, we raise our arms up towards the sky. Gaze up at your thumbs, draw your palms together. You can interlace your fingers if you want to. We're gonna take a nice deep breath and we're gonna start to bring ourselves all the way over to the left, stretching the right side of the body. So you're pushing that right hip out. And if you wanna get even deeper into the stretch, you can bring your right foot behind your left foot, slightly bending that right knee. So you're kind of making yourself a little moon shape. Inhale. And exhale, push that hip away. Gently bring yourself back to center. And let's do the other side. Start to hinge to the right. Feel that stretch down the left side of your body. Push that left hip out. Take your left foot now behind your right foot. Bend your left knee. If you want to get even deeper into that stretch, making yourself a little moon shape. Inhale. And exhale. And gently bring yourself back to center. Take a nice deep inhale, gaze up at your thumbs, extending the spine. And as you exhale, hinging through the hips, bringing yourself back into your forward fold, maybe bend the knees. Inhale, trace your palms up your feet towards your shins or your thighs. Flat back tabletop position, gazing straight ahead. Exhale, drop forward, torso to your thighs. Inhale, trace the palms up the shins towards the thighs. Flatten the back. Draw your navel in. Exhale, forward fold. And last time, trace your palms up your feet, shins and towards your thighs. Flatten the back, draw the navel in, gaze straight ahead. Exhale. Take a nice deep breath here. Walk your hands back down onto the mat. Place your palms nice and flat and either step, float or jump back into your plank position. So from your plank position, I'm just going to adjust the camera again. Make sure that you're just diving through the shoulders ever so slightly. You can either push straight up into your downward dog or you can come down through a mini vinyasa, chaturanga, and up dog, whatever suits you. So pushing back into your down dog or taking your vinyasa, tuck those elbows in, come down, push forward, upward facing dog, and push back, downward facing. Heels down towards the floor, draw that navel in and breathe in. And let's do the other side here. I'm just gonna change sides again so you guys can see. Push down through those palms. Let's inhale our left leg up towards the sky into your three-legged, bending the left knee. And if you want to flex the left foot, really opening up your hips, evenly distribute the weight between your palms and gazing underneath your left armpit. Take a nice deep breath. Take that knee and send it all the way forward to meet your chest. Plant that left foot down in between your hands. Take that right foot back, bring yourself into a lunge. Take those arms up in line with your ears. Hips squared to the front. Drop the shoulders down. Inhale. Exhale, bring your palms down. Drop that knee. Unflex the right foot. Deep inhale here. Feel those hips sinking. Exhale, let's straighten the left leg. Flex the left foot. Draw the torso to the thigh. Deep hamstring stretch. Inhale, bring yourself forward, hinge through the hips back into your low lunge. And breathe, inhale. Exhale, straighten the leg, flex the foot and hinge forward. And bring yourself back, plant that foot, low lunge. Inhale. Last time, bringing yourself back, flexing that foot, deep hamstring stretch. Feel it pull on the back of your left hamstring, keep that spine nice and straight. Inhale. And then gently plant that left foot,
tuck that right foot back under, and we're just going to lift that back leg and bring ourselves back up into our lunge, gazing straight ahead. Inhale, turn out the right foot this time. Open the arms, warrior two, tuck that tailbone under, gaze down those front fingertips. Inhale. Exhale, sit into that front knee bend. Lovely, guys. Take a nice deep inhale here. Hinge forward, turn the left palm upwards, and then send the right hand down the back of the right leg, left arm up and over, reverse your warrior. And maybe take your right arm all the way around your spine to touch your left thigh. Deep inhale here. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, unravel the arms, open the palms and shift your weight forward, keeping those arms open. So if you're happy here, that's lovely. If it's a bit hard, pop your left forearm onto your left thigh and right arm over the top into your extended side angle. And if you want to go further still, take your bind, left arm underneath your left leg, right arm over the top, open that chest out to the side, inhale. And exhale. And inhale, and whichever version you're in, let's straighten both legs. Take a nice deep breath here. And everyone taking your bind, bring those arms open, meet everyone in your triangle pose. Left hand in line with left ankle, right arm up towards the sky. Imagine we're in a toaster, we don't want either side to get burnt. That's why we keep ourselves nice and aligned. If you're uncomfortable in this position, you're probably doing it right. Reaching up towards your right arm. Deep inhale. Exhale, bring both palms down on either side of that front foot. Step the right foot in a little bit, but not a lot. Keep both legs nice and straight. Bring yourself upright. Take your finger and thumb on either side of your hips and steer them to the front. And then we start to hinge forward through the hips into our pyramid pose. If you can, drop that torso to the thigh and bring yourself down. Inhale. And exhale, and inhale, and exhale. Take one more deep inhale here. And exhale. Place your palms flat and step back into your plank position. Either pushing straight up into your downward dog, or if you feel like taking another vinyasa, push forward, tuck those elbows in, chaturanga. Upward facing and downward facing, tuck those toes under. Bring yourself back into that downward facing dog. Walk the feet out, wiggle the hips. You should feel quite nice and warm now. Giving yourself a little sway from side to side. Deep breath and slight bend in your knees, gaze straight ahead and either step, jump or float between your hands into a seated position on your mats. And from here, let's uncross our legs, place your feet nice and flat, feet and knees parallel like train tracks, making sure our sit bones are nice and even. So we're gonna do our boat pose. I'm gonna give you three options. Option number one, we're gonna take our hands out to the side in a kind of V shape. Make sure the spine stays nice and long. And bring your feet into a tabletop position. You can also bring your arms behind you if that helps. Option number two is no arms. You can bring your arms in line with your legs. And option number three, if you feel like this is just way too easy, you can straighten your legs and balance on those sit bones. Keep that spine nice and straight, and let's hold three breaths. Inhale. And exhale. And inhale, stay with me. And exhale, lovely, well done. Inhale, looking good, guys. And exhale, give me one more breath for that. Inhale, and exhale, plant your feet and just drop your chest forward over your knees and give yourself a little hug. And then bring your arms in line with your feet, and you're going to very gently, very slowly start to roll down through your spine. Bring yourself back down onto the mat, one vertebrae at a time. You very, very slowly unraveling, uncurling. Gently rolling back, nice and indulgent. It's good for your abs as well.
Bring yourself back down onto the mat, arms open, palms facing up towards the sky, drop the shoulders down, spine nice and flat, feet hip width apart, placing the feet nice and flat. Deep inhale here. And exhale, let's take a shoulder bridge. So gluing your spine down onto the mat, imagine someone's dotted super glue from the base of your neck all the way down your spine to your tailbone. You don't want to be able to fit a hand underneath your back. If your spine's completely flat, you'll feel a very slight tilt to your pelvis, and that's exactly what we want. Feet and knees about hip width apart, and make sure they're nice and parallel. You don't want them kind of dropping open to the side with your feet turned out. You want to make sure they stay parallel because that will help to activate your glutes and your thighs, which really makes them work in this pose. So your shoulder bridge is really, really good for your pelvic floor. So ladies, especially for you, your pelvic floor is that little hammock of muscles that holds all your pelvic organs in place. It's really, really good to strengthen those muscles. And this is a really, really great pose for that. It's also good for insomnia. It helps reduce stress and anxiety if you take it regularly. So that's why I always pop it in at the end of the class, especially in times like this where it's a little bit all over the place. So it's nice to have a nice little calming stretch at the end. So place your palms down flat in line with your hips. Nice long neck, shoulders and spine in a nice straight line. Inhale. And as you exhale, start to roll those hips up towards the sky, drawing that pelvis upwards. Imagine someone's got a bit of string and they're lifting you up. Keep those hips nice and high. Inhale. And exhale. And really feel that engagement in your glutes, in your bums, in your thighs. Keep those knees and feet parallel, grounding down through your foot. And if you want to, you can walk your shoulders together, interlace your fingers underneath your back. Inhale. And exhale. And inhale. And exhale. Take one more deep breath here. And gently start to roll down through the spine, dropping down onto the mat. Draw your knees in towards your chest and rock from side to side, massaging your spine on the mat and just releasing each vertebrae. We're going to take an inversion to finish because we haven't done many of those since I've been teaching these Zoom classes. So like we did last night, if you do have headstand in your practice, please do feel free to take it now. Ladies, if you are, if it is that time of the month, or anyone that doesn't want to take an inversion, you can either take an early Shavasana, or you can bring your legs straight, back flat on the mat, and your legs off the wall, which is literally as though your legs are against the wall. In fact, if you do have a wall, you can actually push yourself up against that wall with your bum against the wall and your legs against the wall, and bring your arms out in a V shape, keeping that spine nice and flat. Everyone else, we're going to take our shoulder stand. So we're going to make sure that we're nice and aligned in a nice straight line. Drop those shoulders down. Draw your knees in towards you. Take your palms into the small of your back and bring yourself up on your forearms in a nice straight line. So what we want here is to make sure that our neck is nice and free. And you want to try and gaze up at your feet and make sure you're in a nice straight line. So try not to turn your neck too much. You want to keep that alignment balanced. And reaching up, pointing the toes. So you can do variations here. You can take your legs out to the side if you want to. You can bring your feet together above your head like you're a little upside down Buddha. You can take an upside down cross leg. It's completely up to you what you do. And anyone that wants to bring their feet all the way over so that they touch the ground behind you, and bring your arms out to the side in your cow pose. And breathe. This is supposed to be another relaxing one, although I've never found cow particularly relaxing. And if you want to, you can hug your knees into your ears as well.
So whichever version you're doing, take a couple more breaths here. Take a nice deep inhale and very gently, if you're in headstand, bring yourself into your child's pose. Everyone else, we're gently rolling back down onto the mat, peeling ourselves back down out the way we came. And if you've taken legs up the wall or shoulder stand, draw the palms of your hands underneath the small of your back, come up onto your forearms, point your toes and take your fish pose, letting your head drop the whole way back and pushing that chest up towards the sky. Inhale. And exhale. And inhale. And exhale. Take one last deep inhale here and gently start to melt yourself down into the mat. Reach your arms up above your head and you should know the drill by now. Let's take our full body stretch. Point the fingers, point the toes. Imagine someone's got you by the fingertips, someone's got you by the toes. You're reaching, reaching, reaching. You can't get away. I want tension in every single part of your body. This is the biggest stretch that you've done in the whole class. And I want you to pour everything into this stretch, every little bit of tension, tightness, everything that's annoying you, everything that's frustrating you, pour it into this stretch, reaching from one side of the room to the other. They're trying to add inches onto your body. Everything should be tense. That includes your facial features, ugliest face you've ever made. Screw those facial features up. Really, really small, tiny, beady eyes, tiny little nose. Keep reaching. 5, 4, 3, 2. Make the ugliest face. Make a really, really stupid face. 2.5. And 1. Let go. Bring your arms down by your side. Palms open. Drop the shoulders down. If you have a blanket or a jumper, or some socks that you'd like to put on, please do. If you need to take a drink of water, then please do. I recommend taking your shavasana lying on your back, either legs straight or knees bent, whatever feels better for you and your spine. You can also take it lying on your side in a fetal position, but try and pop a cushion between your knees. Pregnant ladies, you should take your shavasana lying on your side. You should not be lying on your backs, unless you have a little prop to support yourself. You can take it seated. I'm going to come to seated just so I can talk to you, but I fully recommend that you take Shavasana lying down. It is a very nice treat to be able to relax for a few minutes. So lying down on your mats with your palms open and your eyes closed, and let's take a nice deep inhale. Drawing the air in towards your lungs all the way to the bottom. Filling them to the top. And as you exhale, reverse the breath. Draw the navel in towards the spine. And again, inhale, expand the abdomen. Draw the air in, filling your lungs all the way from the bottom to the top. And exhale, reversing the breath. Let's take ourselves back to where we were at the beginning of the class. Take that imaginary broom and sweep all your thoughts and worries away. Leaving your head empty and clear. Feel those shoulders dropping away from your ears, creating space between the ears and the shoulders for the neck to grow. Unclench your jaw, unfurrow your brow. Just allow yourself to have this moment that's all about you. Take your attention down to your feet and feel each toe unravel one by one, falling open on the mat. Ankles, calves, knees, and thighs becoming lightweight. All the way up to the base of your spine and feeling each vertebrae unravel one by one.
melting down into the mat. Shoulders dropping down your spine, trickling down, melting into the earth, becoming one with the ground. Leaving your neck long, your jaws soft, your mouth slightly open, and your tongue pulled down away from the roof of your mouth. Make sure those back teeth are not touching and your facial features become soft and gentle. Your head becomes light, free of thoughts and worries, empty and clear. Arms become lightweight at your side with your palms opening, each fingertip unraveling one by one. And finally, we take our attention to our chest and our abdomen, feeling each breath wash through us, washing away any tightness or tension we feel so that we can focus only on that slow and steady rise and fall. Becoming so in tune with our breath and our body that we tune out everything else. Allowing ourselves to melt down into the mat, becoming one with the earth. And giving ourselves this moment of complete and utter calm. With nothing but our breath. Gently start to wiggle your fingers and your toes, draw awareness back into your bodies. Draw your knees in towards your chest and gently rock from side to side to massage your spine on the mat. Rocking all the way over onto the right hand side into your fetal position. And if you want to, you can keep your eyes closed as you gently bring yourself up to seated on your mat, palms facing up towards the sky. Let's take a nice deep inhale. And as we exhale, deep sigh to let everything go. And again, inhale. Exhale, and once more for luck, inhale, draw your palms together at your heart center. Thank you all so much for practicing with me tonight. I hope you have a lovely rest of your evening. Again, as always, if you have any suggestions, it's better to pop them on Facebook, although my stream tonight seems to have died. So you can pop them in the chat here nice and quickly and I'll read them all before I end the meeting. It's so lovely to still be able to connect with all of you and I hope that I see you again tomorrow night. Have a lovely rest of your evening. Stay safe, stay happy. Namaste.
Oh. Thank you, everyone. I'll see you all tomorrow, hopefully. Oh, my internet connection is unstable. Well, I know that. Okay. See you guys tomorrow. Have a lovely evening, whatever you are doing. Oh, I slept a straight 8 hours after yoga last night. Wow, I'm jealous. Okay, guys, I'm going to end the meeting now.